Welcome to BPTV. I'm your host, Andy Amrine, and this is Handy Andy Segments. Today, we're doing a fun segment with the Bethel Park High School. This is with the FCCLA, and I'm going to introduce you to a young lady who has a fabulous idea for turning all those old garbage cans into rain barrel. So tune in. All right, Haley, how about introducing yourself and tell us why we're here today?
Hi, I'm Haley Bell, a freshman at Bethel Park High School. And did you know that all Bethel Park residents are getting a new garbage can this spring?
Okay, well, with us getting new garbage cans, you have a project here for which organization?
For FCCLA, it's okay. A club at school.
And what does that stand for?
Family, Career, Community Leaders of America.
Okay. And you have a competition coming up here soon?
Yeah, okay. On March 20th.
Okay, on March 20th. And with this FCCLA competition about family, careers, and so forth, what is the project that you are looking at or have thought of?
Environmental Ambassador. And for that, we're trying to better the community to be more environmentally friendly.
Okay.
And
that's important.
Yeah.
Yes. Are you environmentally friendly?
I try to be.
You try to be? Okay. Yeah. And is that where this rain barrel type of idea came up from?
Yeah.
Okay. So tell us a little bit about the idea, and you said Bethel Park, we're all getting new garbage cans, and what were you afraid of that the people were going to do with all the old cans?
I was afraid that all of the garbage cans were just going to go to the dump.
To the landfills.
Yeah.
Right. So you have an idea that nobody should be throwing them out, correct?
Yeah.
And this just popped into your brain one day? You woke up and said, I want to make rain barrels? Or were you doing some research or something about this?
I was doing some research prior to.
Have you had a rain barrel at your home before, or a friend or neighbor or something?
I have not, but okay. I've seen people online use rain barrels, and they said that they were very useful and they liked using them. So.
Okay, so the idea of a rain barrel is what? Where's all the water coming from?
Well, there's a lot of rain.
Okay.
And
understood.
We have most people don't save the rain and use it for like watering their plants or drinking. But
these are rain barrels. We're just not going to sit in the front yard. You want to be collecting the water off of the houses, correct?
Yeah.
Okay, and why don't you walk us through your design of what a rain barrel and a garbage can is?
So we made it out of a garbage can, and it just connects to your house from the downspout, and it collects into here from the downspout. And then at the bottom, there's a spigot, and you can collect the water out of the bottom.
Okay, so and all this is very simple. You've made this can all by yourself?
Yeah.
Okay, and the ideas with it is you take your garbage can. Do you want people to check it for leaks or clean it or anything first? Is that important?
You should definitely clean it because there could be like old garbage stuck in the bottom. You want to make sure it's clean. That way, like if you are watering your plants, no chemicals from any of the waste gets in your plants.
Okay, and the big holes up here, this is something you're going to show us how to cut that, and you did this all by yourself. This is just a very simple cut. And this little spout and a hose off the side of it, what is this designed for? Because this is at the top of the barrel.
Yeah, so that prevents water from getting stuck inside.
It's like an overflow?
Yeah, it's an overflow, and it just prevents too much pressure.
Okay, so if the barrel gets too full and you haven't used it, it'll just trickle out and it'll drain to wherever it is you have the hose on it. And I'm going to pick up the can you have down here at the bottom. This is your regular spout.
Yeah.
And this is one that when you're ready to water with, you can just have a hose attached to it and turn it on and turn it off like you would any type of spout.
Yep.
Okay, and this is a project that you can use on really any size garbage can, can't you?
Yeah.
There's no limitations on 20, 30, 50, 90, 100, any number of cans you have.
Yep. It's, I tried to make it so that almost anyone could do it.
Mm-hmm.
That way there wasn't an excuse
to
not
recycle. No excuses.
Yeah.
So if you drive around the neighborhood after we post all this on BPTV and you see someone throwing out the garbage can, you're going to stop and holler at them?
Yeah.
And hand them one of your flyers and say, no, do this, do this.
Mm-hmm.
That's your goal?
Yeah.
Okay. And you're going to win your competition in March?
Yeah.
Ah, good answer. Well, we're anxious to see you actually put all this together. This is an amazing project. I'm really excited about it. Did we miss anything on your explanations? You know, all the parts you're using are readily available at hardware stores?
Yeah.
You know.
We found all of this at our local hardware store.
Okay. Very good. Well, why don't you show us how to put it all together, all right? All right, Haley, why don't you take us through your list of everything that you need to make these rain barrels. So starting at the top, of course, you need your old garbage can.
What else
do we need?
You need a 3/4-inch hose bib, which is the spout at the bottom of the garbage can.
Okay.
You need a plastic downspout connector, which connects the downspout. You need a pipe connector, downspout elbows, 1-inch fender washer, garden hose, female hose connector, silicone sealant, blocks to raise the barrel, fiberglass window screen, and epoxy.
All right, Haley, we're going to start by having you actually design or put all this together for us now. And so where do we start? Show us what we're starting with.
So you want to take your pipe adapter and trace it on the lid of the garbage can wherever, like, it would be most suitable for you on your garbage can. Perhaps it's probably about like in the back. So I'm just gonna trace around it.
Okay. And I noticed that with the pipe adapter you're using, we're using a threaded one because you have lock nuts that are gonna be on the top and the bottom of the threads, and that keeps it from sliding into the garbage can or falling totally out of the garbage can.
Yeah. So then we're going to take our X-Acto knives, and we're just going to cut it out with the X-Acto knife.
Mm-hmm.
You got to be very careful with this, so you have to take your time. It's going to take a long time.
That's all right. Haley, what are you doing now? You already got the center out, so now what are you doing?
We're just making the hole a little bit bigger.
Okay, and why is that?
To make it fit. Because when we traced it, it didn't trace like the size all the way perfectly, so just fixing that up.
All right. Okay, using the lock ring to trace it. The lock ring gives you the outside dimension of the thread, because the lock ring has so much surface area, even if you cut the hole a little bit bigger, the lock ring is going to hold everything into place.
That makes sense.
It's one of the reasons we use the lock rings.
Yes, so.
Okay, so Haley, we're going to use two lock nuts, right?
Does this one go up or down?
That's correct.
Right, like this?
Right. And what do the lock nuts do?
It keeps this adapter from sliding into the can or out of the can.
Right. So we use one outside the can and one inside the can lid. There you go.
Okay, so now I'm going to put the other lock nut onto the bottom of it, or the bottom of the lid.
Okay, it looks perfect. So what do we do next?
So now we can drill the ventilation holes.
Okay, and what do we need ventilation holes for?
Well, we don't want too much pressure to build up in the can, so okay. We need to let some air out. Because if there's water coming in here, it'll push the air out.
Okay. And show us what you do or how you do those.
So we're just going to put some ventilation holes in with this drill. You can put one to three, depending on how big your garbage can is. So.
And placement really doesn't matter.
Yeah, you can put it anywhere on the lid of the garbage can.
Okay.
So I'm just going to mark, put a dot, about right here. I'm going to put it right here.
And we're just using a cordless drill and
yeah.
You have...
Or if you don't have a drill, you could
use your X-Acto knife. Again? Okay. And what size hole are you drilling in there?
This is
a one inch.
1 inch.
Okay. And have the dot. Yeah, have that tip in the dot when you go. And just downward pressure. Okay, so Haley, what's the next thing we have to do here?
We need to drill a hole for our spout
okay.
to go into so that the water can come out of the bottom.
Okay.
You want to do this fairly close to the bottom of the can. That way you can use up all the water in the can.
Okay, but you need to pick a flat area?
You need to pick, flat area.
And you're going to use your drill again to do this?
Yeah.
Okay.
Or your X-Acto knife if you don't have a drill.
Okay.
So I'm just going to mark.
Mark a spot.
Could you hold that mm-hmm. still? Okay.
And then you generally use a rubber seal so it doesn't leak out in the lock nut you're putting on the inside of the can. That's good.
That's good? Okay. Okay, and then we're going to put the lock nut in on the inside of the can.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay, Haley, we have one more hole to drill.
Yep.
And that hole's going to be for what?
The overflow.
Okay. And this is just if it's raining so hard in the barrel, instead of it overflowing, it'll go into this spout and down
yep.
through the hose.
I'm just going to mark a hole about in the middle there.
Mm-hmm. Somewhere closer to the top.
Okay, and then I'm going to put the hose connector. We're going to put that on there. So this one just goes in there like that. There you go.
Okay. Okay, Haley, so on the overflow tube then, this is where you normally just attach a garden hose and leave it on all the time for if the can overflows, it just goes down the hose to wherever you're draining it to.
Yeah, and you could put that end maybe in a garden so that it would automatically just go to the garden or
okay.
flower bed. So it just screws onto there.
Okay, and the last couple of things, you brought a tube of silicone with you.
Yes.
And you want people to use those where?
This would go around any of your adapters or your...
On the inside of the
can.
Just extra protection so nothing leaks out for it.
Yeah.
Okay.
This is just extra.
All right, and then what's this last pipe fitting you have here?
So this will just connect here.
Just slides in. Okay, and you need that, why?
It attaches to like your downspout. It just goes in.
And you could slide it in as deep as you want or as shallow as you want, and mm-hmm. even put a screw in there if you need to tighten it in there secure.
Yep.
Well, Haley Bell, congratulations. It's a gorgeous looking rain barrel, and it is something that all the residents of Bethel Park can do. That was a very simple project. And anything else that people should know or could do with these rain barrels?
Well, you could paint it or decorate it with just like acrylic paint and make it look like it's a part of your garden.
Right. So it's a nice family project.
Yeah.
You know, everyone should take part in it, and it's very environmentally, you know, sound. So thank you for your time and sharing this fabulous idea, and good luck at the FCCLA competition coming up. I'm sure you're going to win.
Thank you.
Wow. Haley Bell, thank you very much for spending the afternoon with us and telling us what we could do with all these garbage cans that I was wondering myself what everyone was going to be doing for them. So thank you for watching BPTV. I'm your host, Andy Amrine, and we'll see you soon.